Can't decide between Magento open source and Adobe Commerce for your business? Don't worry, in just a few minutes, you will have a much better idea of which version is more suited for you. Hey, it's Robert here from ScandiWeb. We have been working with Magento since its first release in 2008. And in this video, we want to share our knowledge with you. Make sure to stick around till the end, because I'll be sharing exclusive access to a comprehensive guide on how to migrate your Magento 1 store to M2. This guide contains expert knowledge that will help you seamlessly upgrade your online store and take your business to the next level. Adobe is a powerful platform with a strong reputation that once again has been recognized as digital commerce leader in a recent report by Gartner. As we can see here, Adobe's commerce popularity is growing rapidly among the top 10K websites across the internet. Choosing an e-commerce platform that's right for your business needs and goals isn't easy. So let's compare cost, maintenance, scalability, and different features. Adobe Commerce and Magento Open Source are two different e-commerce options from Adobe. The main difference between these two is that Magento Open Source is the free open source option, while Adobe Commerce is a premium paid-for option. Magento Open Source delivers all the basic e-commerce capabilities to build an online store from the ground up. Additionally, the platform is fully customizable, with all the extensions available on Adobe Commerce Marketplace. Many of the important e-commerce capabilities that aren't built in with the platform can be easily added. This version is not only suitable for a small retailer or someone just starting out, but also for medium enterprises that demand more functionality. Adobe Commerce has all the features available to Magento Open Source, plus many more. It includes an extensive list of features and functionalities you would otherwise need to build yourself with the free version. Adobe Commerce is the best option for medium to large businesses. While the Magento open source version itself is free, using it entails costs related to hosting, extensions, themes, customizations, and others. Adobe Commerce has a license fee, which is based on annual gross merchandise value and average order value. Magento open source doesn't include additional support. So if you have your own development team, that's great, because maintaining Magento open source could be all on you. You can also hire a third-party Magento development agency, like us, to take care of it. Either way, keep in mind that Magento open source regularly gets updated, so your team needs to be able to keep up. You can always ask the Magento community for help in resolving issues you encounter, but you cannot rely on it for support. Opposite of that is Adobe Commerce, which offers not only technical support, but also Customer Success Manager. This is a great advantage that would ensure your store is running smoothly with 24/7 support. An important downside to Magento Open Source is scalability. If your business is growing very fast, you can outgrow the platform because of its database limitations. Magento Open Source only supports a single database system, which means your website could perform slower if you have multiple websites and storefronts. If your business receives significantly higher traffic, has ambitious growth plans, and processes a great volume of orders daily, Adobe Commerce is the best option for you. If you're currently on Magento Open Source and finding that the platform is no longer meeting your needs, consider upgrading to Adobe Commerce. From a security point of view, Adobe Commerce is significantly more advanced than Magento Open Source. Magento Open Source lacks credit card tokenization and advanced payment security. The free version also doesn't comply with PCI DSS security. The paid version, on the other hand, is a pre-certified PCI Level 1 infrastructure, and it also comes with integrated payment gateways that allow merchants to securely transmit credit card data, making payment card industry PCI compliance easier. Both versions share similar core features, such as integrated checkout, payment and shipping, mobile-optimized shopping, global selling, catalog management, extended functionality via App Marketplace, instant purchase, site search, and WYSIWYG page builder. Remember, additional extensions that aren't built in with this version can be easily added. Additionally, Adobe Commerce provides some more powerful features and advanced functionality across different areas, such as B2B functionality, business intelligence dashboards, advanced marketing tools, content staging and preview, customer loyalty tools, visual merchandising, customer segmentation, live search, and gift cards. Adobe Commerce is offered as a part of Adobe Experience Cloud, a collection of solutions designed to help businesses make informed decisions and deliver enhanced customer experiences based on insights and data. This includes applications and services covering content and commerce, data and audiences, customer journeys, marketing workflow, and digital enrollment. Adobe Commerce also comes with additional support from Adobe. I want to emphasize two integrated features that come with Adobe Commerce. The first one is the B2B capabilities that are designed to make managing orders easier for B2B customers. Some of the features are customer-specific catalogs and pricing, quick order forms, order and quote tracking, and self-service customer portals. The second one is Adobe Target, which is AI-powered functionality. In short, it's Adobe's solution for testing, automation, and personalization. It allows merchants or marketers to personalize and experiment with content and experiences to improve revenue, conversions, and engagement across different customer touchpoints. All of Adobe Commerce's advanced functionalities and features give enterprises a lot of room to grow and the ability to improve the commerce experiences they provide their customers at scales not possible with the Magento open source, which means much higher conversions, greater revenue, and more opportunities to excel at multi-channel fulfillment.
As promised at the beginning of the video, here is the comprehensive Magento migration guide. All you have to do is click on the link in the description and enter your name and email address. The guide will take you through 9 chapters that will show you how to seamlessly migrate your Magento 1 store to Magento 2 ecosystem to handle your growing business.
Once again, the decision as to whether to use Magento Open Source or Adobe Commerce goes down to the details of your business needs and overall digital strategy, so make sure you carefully consider all the points we covered today. If you enjoyed watching this video, you might also find this webinar about B2B e-commerce helpful. Click on the screen now if you want to take a closer look. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next video.